This week, as I said, I hosted the annual Tom Hughes Oration at the Opera House. For those who aren't aware, Tom was the first member for Barowra, a former Attorney General and one of the fiercest barristers this country has ever seen in action. He's also the last surviving Liberal minister from that long period of coalition rule between 1949 and 1972. He flew fighter jets against the Nazis in the Second World War too, and more importantly, in my opinion, he is a genuinely decent fellow who just turned 100.
This, for me, is a great occasion, and I feel very fortunate to be here.
The event was organised by the current member for Barowra, Julian Leeser, who has been an anti-Semitism champion long before October 7, but sadly, he's been much busier since. He chose the Opera House for, well, obvious reasons.
6 months ago, this very day, an angry mob claimed the Opera House and they basically chanted unspeakable slogans about their fellow Australians. And tonight we are reclaiming the Opera House for all Australians.
Peter Dutton was a guest of honour and spoke brilliantly. John Howard was there too. The highlight of my night was sitting next to him whilst the Leader of the Opposition spoke and listening to the delightful Mr Howard's commentary throughout. It was a real treat. And it was very positive, by the way, too. Now, before proceedings began, I sat with the former Australian Prime Minister and shot an interview for you, my audience, and asked him how he felt the government was handling the war in Gaza. He did not hold back, particularly when it came to Foreign Minister Penny Wong's comments this week regarding a Palestinian state. Let me give you a little preview of what he said.
I think this government, and Penny Wong in particular, has demonstrably failed to react in the right way to the attack on Israel on the 7th of October last year. There were more Jews killed in that attack than in any incident since the Holocaust. And I am just staggered that the government didn't from the get-go say, whatever differences we have, we must never, ever sound as though we don't care about the re-emergence of anti-Semitism.
Now, there's plenty more he said as well, and also takes the current government to task on border security. Those comments are fascinating. That's coming up a little bit later in the show. Now, back to the oration and the reason Mr Leeser determined the Opera House was the right location for this event. The claiming back, per se, of a place that brought international shame on this country. To prove that the Opera House belongs to all Australians, Jewish included, and that it will not be defined by those horrific images of the celebration of death and slaughter that went around the world on October 9 last year. In the audience, there were Australians of all different backgrounds and faiths, and the desire for this country to be united and fight back against extremism of all types was a recurring theme. Living in this day and age is like a roller coaster for me sometimes. I don't know how you guys at home feel. I have moments of exasperation and fear that our country is heading down a despicable path from which there is no coming back. But then I feel immense hope and joy. There are young people who understand how the world works and don't struggle to differentiate between good and evil, regardless of how murky some try to make it all seem. I met some of those young people at that event this week and they calm me a little bit. But regrettably, they aren't enough. It takes immense courage to stand up for what you believe in and to speak your mind, especially to a hostile crowd. But we must, or else the evil forces will win. We must encourage our young to open their eyes, to research, learn, not to recycle rubbish fed to them on social media from extremists and those who wish to do us harm. We must never become a mouthpiece for the likes of Hamas or any other terrorist organisation, regardless of how cunning their modus operandi might be. Freedom and democracy are the cornerstones of our great nation, and we must protect them at all costs. Otherwise, what's the point? When I see children marching not for Palestine but for Hamas, my heart breaks. I don't know anyone who isn't deeply affected by the loss of life in Gaza, just as they are equally dismayed by the hostages still held captive there. But we must maintain our moral clarity. No country is perfect, ours included. But we must never condone the kind of barbarism we saw on October 7, let alone reward those responsible. Otherwise, sooner than you think, we may see more of it in more places, including here on our own precious soil.